हेलो, वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. वेलकम टू बायजूस एग्जाम प्रेप, द मोस्ट कॉम्प्रिहेंसिव प्रिपरेशन ऐप फॉर ऑल एग्जामिनेशन. दिस इज सूरज गोपी. आई वेलकम यू ऑल टू दिस प्रैक्टिस सेशन ऑफ थ्योरी ऑफ मशीन एंड इंजीनियर मैकेनिक्स. तो एक बार सभी लोग जल्दी से ज्वाइन करेंगे एंड प्लीज यू लेट मी नो एवरीथिंग इज परफेक्ट विद द ऑडियो एंड वीडियो. हेलो, वेरी वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून, गुड आफ्टरनून. Do join us and we'll be solving very quick questions for BARC 2021 for the two important subjects, theory of machines, vibration and engineering mechanics. Okay, so everything is perfect, right, with the audio and video? All good? Yes or no? Good, very, very good afternoon, good afternoon. Okay. So we'll be practicing some questions related to the two subjects, that is theory of machines and engineering mechanics, and let's see how much is your preparation level for these two subjects. So let us begin. Yes, chaliye to start karte hain hamara aaj ka session of practice session for theory of machine and your engineering mechanics. So let me introduce about myself. My name is Suraj Gopi. I usually deal with mechanics, thermal applied, heat transfer, industrial engineering and theory of machine for GATE, ESE and AEG. Okay. And this is my personal Telegram channel, that is Learn with Suraj. You can connect with me where you will be getting the PDFs of all the session, right? Hello, hello Ankit, good afternoon. Hello Mithun. Gate questions, yeah, definitely gate level questions will be there. Some easy questions, some difficult questions, some unique conceptual questions, which will be covering entire syllabus of theory of machine and engineering mechanics. Okay, so let's start the session. Anyone having any difficulty? Right now you can tell me the comment section. Perfect. So let's start the session, because a lot number of questions we'll be discussing. Approximately 25 number of questions we'll be discussing. So I want everyone to be as quick, like should be quick to join the session. Okay. Hello Ved. Hello. Hello. All good. Chaliye. So there's an offer going on the BYJUS exam prep for online classroom, a flat 25% off. You can use this code, that is extra 25, to avail this 25% off on the online classroom, right? Chaliye. So let's go for the first question. Very easy problem. At resonance, the amplitude of viscous damped vibration is. What is the amplitude of viscous damped vibration at resonance? Is it very large? Is it option B maximum? Is it option C zero? Or is it option D? Let's see who will be giving me the correct answer. Option A, option B, option C or option D. Yes, quickly. A, B, C or D. First question on your screen. Everyone. Mithun, Ved, Ankit. What is the correct answer for this question? One A, B, C, or this is a question that many of the students will be making mistake. Ankit is going with option D. Parvinder is going with option A. Anyone else? Look, if in order to answer this problem, read the question carefully. They are not saying undamped system. There is damping in the system. It's a viscous damp. Okay, your damping coefficient damping factor is not equal to zero. It is having some finite value. And if you see the graph for amplitude versus omega by omega n, you see the graph between amplitude and omega by omega n, right? So it will be having a value 1 at omega equal to 0. It will be going like this, infinity, and at resonance condition, omega by omega n equal to 1. Okay. But for the rest, this is only for undamped, that is zeta equal to 0. Zeta equal to 0 ke liye hoga. If I talk about any other values, we'll be having graph like this. It will be having high magnitude, but it will not be having maximum. Maximum kaha hoga? It is slightly less than that of omega by omega n. So maximum to nahi hoga. It would not be infinity, it would not be zero, it will be very large. Option A is the correct answer. Clear? It is not option D. Option D is only feasible when your zeta equal to zero. Question mein kya hai? It is Viscous damped, your zeta is not equal to zero. Make sure you're not committing this mistake. बहुत लोग जल्दबाजी में दे थिंक दैट एट रेजोनेंस एम्पलीट्यूड इज इन्फिनिटी. भाई एम्पलीट्यूड इज ओनली इन्फिनिटी इफ योर जीटा इक्वल टू जीरो, देन ओनली योर एम्पलीट्यूड विल बी टेंडिंग टू इन्फिनिटी, राइट? ऑप्शन ए इज द करेक्ट आंसर. डन एवरीवन, प्लीज डू लेट मी नो एवरीथिंग इज करेक्ट. It's a very easy question, but many of the students in a hurry, they will be thinking there is no damping. Bhai, damping to hai, they are directly written. It's a viscous damping vibration. Chale, next question. A single degree of freedom vibrating system has mass 1 kg and stiffness is 100 newton per meter. The damping coefficient is 10 newton a second per meter. To make the system critically damped, what should be the what you should be doing? What you should be doing in order to make the system critically damped? Yes. A, B, C, or D. What you should be doing in order to make the system to be critically damped? Quickly. Option A, option B, option C, or option D. So calculate the value of critically damped coefficient, CC. Calculate the value of CC. CC is equal to 2 under root K into M. 2 under root k into m. So 2 under root k value is 100 into 1. This is equal to 20. It's equal to 20. 20 newton second per meter. Right? What is the value of c? The c value is 10. So in order, because you have to make it critically damped, that means zeta should be equal to 1. Zeta is equal to c by cc. In order to make both value equal to 1, I have to make the damping twice the value. Option C, bhai, read the question carefully. Option D is not correct. Dekho, CC and C are not equal. C kitna hai? 10. CC is 20. In order to make it equal to CC, you have to increase the damping coefficient by double. Option C is the correct answer. Is this clear? Read the question carefully. There might be possibility that aapne question kara hoga, but values kuch aur hongi. Right? So make sure you're not falling into that trap. Okay, option C is the correct answer. Everyone, done? Mithun, Devinder, Trish, Pavan, clear? Option C is absolutely correct. Very good. Option C is the correct answer. Chaliye, next question. Aap log ke screen pe. Anyone having any doubt in this? Anyone having any doubt in this? Option C. Simple, you have to calculate the critical damping coefficient, that is CC. In order to make critically damping, your zeta should be equal to 1. So C ko aapko twice karna padega in order to convert into a 20 value. Option C. Next question on your screen. A rod AB of length 5 meter remains at the same vertical plane and its end A and B are constrained to remain in contact with the horizontal floor and with the vertical wall respectively. The velocity at point P, which is at 3 meter distance from B, will be if VB is equal to 10 meter per second. The velocity at point B is equal to 10 meter per second. We have to calculate what is the velocity at point P. What is the velocity at point P? Quickly. What is the velocity at point P? Yes. Kaise karein? Ye raha aapke samne. Right? This is the question that you are having. You have to calculate what is the value of V. EB value is already given, that is 10 meter per second. And 3 meter length is given. The length of the rod is 5 meter. That is all. Chaliye, how to calculate? You can go for instantaneous center method. You can go for IC method. Achha, is AB link, if I talk about the link AB, where will be the IC located? IC kis taraf hoga? Your IC will be located somewhere around here. The intersection point of these two. This will be the location of IC. This will be the IC location. Let's say this point is Q. Point is Q. So we know the value of VB. So I can say VB is equal to BQ into omega AB. R into omega hota hai. Your velocity is nothing but R into omega. Right? So omega AB, you can directly calculate omega AB is equal to VB is 10. What is the length BQ? For that, you have to calculate angle. Angle is directly given. This is 37 degree. So this will be 5 cos 37. we got the value of omega b. So in order to get the value of vp, that will be equal to the distance pq into omega ab, kyunki jo point p hai that is located on the link ab itself, right? So aapko calculate karna hai the length pq. How to calculate length pq? Join this line. So pq will be equal to 3 square plus what will be this length? This is 3 cos 37. 3 cos 37, right? Perpendicular distance वहाँ से खींच, 3 cos 37, ठीक है? Yes or no? Sin 37. EQ will be equal to 3 sin 37, right? Yes or no? So this is you can use cosine rule. P sine 37 whole square minus 2 into 3 into 3 sine 37 into cos of under root of. एक बार जल्दी से चेक करेंगे एवरीवन. Everyone quickly, jaldi. A, B, C, or D. Please cross check the values. PQ length, how to calculate this PQ length? That is the main challenge. Because 337 nahi ho sakta, I think, because this is not 90 degree. So we cannot take this as 3 sine 37. Make sure you are not problem. Okay. How to calculate length PQ? PQ kaise nikalenge? What is this length? This length is 5 cos 57. So if you take the triangle, if this is 37, okay, this is 3, this is 5 cos 37. So this PQ will be equal to under root of 3 square plus 5 cos 37 ka square minus 2 into 3 into 5 cos 37 into cos 37. Right? Ab theek hai? Yes or no? So you can use cosine rule, get the value of PQ. ठीक है, यूज कोसाइन विल गेट द वैल्यू पी क्यू. 3 स्क्वायर प्लस 5 कॉस 37 का स्क्वायर माइनस 2 इंटू 3 इंटू 5 कॉस 37 इंटू कॉस 37. सो फ्रॉम हेयर यू विल बी गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ पी क्यू. व्हाट इज द वैल्यू पी क्यू आर गेटिंग? यस, 2.41 मीटर. आपका पी क्यू के वैल्यू इज 2.41 मीटर. ठीक है, सो व्हाट इज ओमेगा? दिस विल बी अप्रोक्सीमेटली 2.5 रेडियन पर सेकेंड. सो फ्रॉम दीज टू इट विल बी इक्वल टू VP will be equal to 2.4 into 2.5, approximately 6.1 something will be the answer. 6.04, option B is the correct answer, right? Okay, देखो 2.5 into 2.5, 6.25 होता है. 6.25 से थोड़ा सा कम होगा, that is 6.04 meter per second. Option B is the correct answer. You have to use instantaneous velocity method. This is a very important, the very important method, because many of you are not able to solve this type of questions. It's very easy. Okay, aapko ye easy question rehta, it's very easy question, but you have to apply basic concept, that is instantaneous velocity. Humne kya kiya? Dekho, understood kaise karte hain? Let us suppose this was the triangle. Theek hai, this angle is 37. Okay, this was P, this was Q. Ye length 3 tha, this was 5 cos, right? How to calculate the length PQ? PQ will be equal to, if I take this point as B, so this will be equal to BP square plus BQ square minus 2BP into BQ into cos 30 under. Cosine rule lagaya, that's it. Okay. Those who are not able to understand this PQ length, that is the formula that I have applied. 3 square, okay, 3 square plus minus 3 into 5 cos 37 into cos 37 omega a. already calculated. From that, we have calculated the value. Yeah. Okay, next question. For a mechanism shown in the figure, which of the following is correct for crank rocker mechanism? Hide myself. Which of the following will be telling us about the crank rocker mechanism? So which one should be your crank and which one should be your rocker? Chaliye. Which one should be your crank and which one should be your rocker? So in order to have crank rocker mechanism, adjacent to the shortest should be fixed. This is your, this shortest should be fixed. Okay. The shortest should be your input and output will be this. This will be your output. In order to have crank rocker mechanism. Okay. Now in this case, shortest link is 30. Your CD should be crank. CD should be crank and AB your rocker. So CD is crank, AB is rocker. Option B is the correct answer. Is this clear? Option B, simple. Crank rocker mechanism you have to identify. So crank rocker kaise hota hai? Adjacent to the shortest link is being fixed. Adjacent to the shortest link is being fixed. So from that logic, you are calculating the crank rocker. Is this clear? Yes. Because shortest link hai na, you want crank rocker. That means input should be given to the crank and crank is the smallest link. That is 30. Right? Chaliye, next question. Thoda speed badhate hai. Let's increase the speed. We are having a following figure as shown in the diagram. You have to tell me what is the force in the member of AC. Very basic. What is the force in the member of AC? Chaliye. What is the force in the member of AC? This is A. This is C. You have to calculate this. So we can see this is a hinge point. This is a roller support. This is a roller support. So at point A will be having RA. Be having RA. FAC. And will be having FA. No force is supporting FAC. That means it is. No force is supporting FAC. No force support karne wala kuch nahi. Take the joint A. Joint A. Zero force in the member AC. Zero force in. Here. Okay. Zero force. Now okay. Figure is now okay. Simple question. Zero force member. Here. Hai. Perfect. Perfect. Very good. Chali, next question on your screen. A pendulum of length L hangs on the roof of a train moving with an uniform acceleration A. Then in the equilibrium position, the pendulum will be. What will be the position of the pendulum at equilibrium position? That means it was hanging on the roof of the train. Suddenly the train is moving. Then what will happen? The new position of the pendulum will be something like this. Okay. With a new position. The new position. Right. So definitely at this point of time on this pendulum will be having an inertia force acting. Will be having a tension T. This is your angle theta. This is angle theta having force. You have to tell me what will be the equilibrium position of the pendulum. Simple, you have to calculate the value of theta. Theta ki value nikalni hai aapko. Calculate the value of theta for getting this particular answer. Chaliye quickly. Quickly, guys. What is the value of theta? So it will be T cos theta is equal to mg and T sin theta is equal to ma. Take the ratio, you'll be getting tan theta is equal to be having it will be a by g. A by g, so theta is equal to tan inverse a by g. Option B is the correct answer. Very good. Sahana, no, it won't be C. It will be moving backward, na? It won't be moving forward. Definitely option C and D you can directly eliminate. The train is moving in the forward direction. The pendulum will be moving in the backward direction. Obviously. Option B is the correct answer. Done. Let us proceed for the next question. Next problem on your screen. Chaliye jaldi jaldi, we'll be having quick question solution of your engineering mechanics and theory of machine. Vibration ke questions abhi aayenge jaldi se. A crushed ore is dropped on a conveyor belt at a rate of 300 kg per second. The belt moves at a speed of 2 meter per second. The net force acting on the belt that keeps it moving at the same speed. So we are having a belt, okay? The iron ore is dropped at a rate of 300 kg per second. 300 kg per second, right? You have to tell me what is the force acting on, net force acting on the belt that keeps it moving at the same speed. Chaliye. What is force? It is rate of change of momentum. What is force? It is rate of change of momentum, right? So quickly, you have to tell me what will be the correct formulation. Very good option. देखो units को match कीजिए. Always remember that match the units will be getting the answer. कभी भी mechanics में if you are having any difficulty, always go for matching the units. बहुत सारे problems आपके solve हो जाते हैं. So what is force? Rate of change of linear momentum. Rate of change of linear momentum is m into v minus u divided by t. Right? Rate of change of linear, it is dropped. That means your initial velocity will be equal to zero. I can say this is m into v by t. That is m dot into v. That is 300 into 2. That is 6. Option D is the correct answer. Always remember that whenever you are solving questions, specifically of engineering mechanics, aapke questions bahut baar aise hote hain that you will be getting units. By using the units concept, you will be able to solve the question. Theek hai? Option D. Very good, Anjan. Very good. Sahana, clear? Mithun, very good. Very good, perfect. Very good. Option D is the correct answer. Theek hai? Chaliye, next problem. Will be increasing the pace because there's a marathon going on, formula revision, to uspe bhi aap log jaoge. So let's quickly solve the question. The very easiest question, I would rather say. Consider a four bar mechanism shown in the given figure. The input link OA is rotating. Input link OA is rotating at 200 rpm, uniformly at 200 rpm. Okay, what is the relative velocity of B with respect to A? What is the relative velocity of B with respect to A? Is it 20? Is it 10? Is it 50? For answering to this problem, I would rather say you should not be taking more than 5 seconds to answer this question. Isko answer karne ke liye, you should not be taking more than 5 seconds. It's a very easy question. Dekho. When the two links are parallel and perpendicular to the base, so the velocity at point B, let's say this is VB, this VA, they both will be having same velocity. VA will be equal to VB. If the two velocities are same, relative velocity will be option D. Option D is a correct. VA is equal to, we have solved so many type of questions. Okay, many questions we have solved. Some like, let us suppose if I want to calculate what is the RPM of link BC. Can you tell me what is the RPM of link BC? Can anyone tell me what is the RPM of link BC? Anyone? It is VA is equal to VB. VA is equal to VB. So I can say RA omega A is equal to RB omega B, right? So I can calculate NA to RA equal to RB. So NB comes out to be RA is 10 into 200 divided by 5, that is equal to 400. Okay, your NB will be coming out to be 400 RPM. Can expect a question like this also. आप ऐसे भी questions expect कर सकते. Okay, 400 RPM. The other question that you can expect from this part. Okay, very good, Parvinder, Sahana, Anjan, done. चलिए next question on your screen. देखते हैं what is the next question. Okay. When the addenda and pinion of a wheel is such that the path of approach and path of recess are the maximum possible values, then the length of path of contact is given by. That means the path of approach and path of recess are the maximum values. So what will be the length of path of contact from the gears topic? Tell you quickly. Let us draw that diagram. Base circle, pitch circle, your line of action. Let us suppose this is, I'm taking as pinion. So what is, let's say this point is M. So this will be the maximum length of the path of recess. Okay. So this will be R, this is phi. So this is R cos and this is R sine phi. Similarly, we will be having, read the question, guys. Changes hain aaj, bahut sare questions mein, we will be having changes. Hide myself. Ye aapka pitch circle for the second. The pitch circle for the second one. The base circle. The dotted line. So NP is equal to, let's say this is equal to capital R, this will be phi, this R sine phi, and PM is equal to small r sine phi. That is the maximum value that you're having. So your length of path of contact, that is NM. NM is the length of path of contact, that will be equal to R sine phi plus small r sine phi. That is equal to R plus small r in option. They are asking you what is the maximum value, because the path of approach and path of recess individually they are having the maximum possible. That means they are at the limiting condition. I hope you know that limiting case, limiting condition, that is the maximum value of a path of approach and path of recess. This is the distance r. Ye aapka distance r hai. Okay. Perpendicular, this will be r sine phi, capital R sine phi. Okay. R sine phi, so the total will be the path of contact. So option D. Yes, Arun. Option B kaise ho gaya? Cos to aayega hi nahi. It will be having a sine component. It will be having a sine component. Clear? Okay, so this is your maximum length of path of contact. Of path. This clear? Yes or no? Done. Questions are very easy, only conceptual questions. That's it. Tell the next question on your screen. The sun gear in the figure is driven clockwise and is at rotating at 125 rpm. Okay, so we're having a sun gear. The rpm of the sun gear is 125 rpm in the clockwise direction. Okay. The annular gear is fixed. That means N of annular gear is equal to 0. What is the rpm? What is the rpm? Chaliye, quickly. What is the RPM of the arm? Annular gear is the external gear. This is internal teeth, right? The extreme most be the biggest gear, having number of teeth equal to 65. You can go for that approach, epicyclic gear train approach. So what is the RPM of the sun? That is X plus Y, where I'm assuming N of arm is equal to Y. N of planet is equal to Y minus X TS by TP. And the RPM of annular gear is equal to Y minus X ES by ES. Quickly. That table. But if you have solved question, many questions, then it will be very easy. No need to draw the table. No need to draw the table. You can now directly write the relations. Now, according to this problem, your which gear is fixed? Your annular gear is fixed. That means this is equal to 0. And RPM sun gear, this is equal to 120. So I'm having two equations, TS and TA, every individual number of teeth is given. This is 25, this is 15, 65. Okay, so you can get the value. The equations will be X plus Y is equal to 125, and Y minus X, TS, number of teeth on the sun gear is 15, and annual gear is 65. 15, by 65 equals to, so y is equal to x 15 by 65. So place this value over here, we'll be getting the value of x. Okay, get the value of y because I need to calculate the RPM of the arm. This y value, I need to calculate the RPM of the arm. Quickly solve it and tell me what's the answer. We'll be having x plus 15x by 65 equal to 125. So x value will be 125 into 65 divided by 70 plus 1080. We're getting the value of x. Okay. So put that value over here. So y will be equal to 125 minus x. You're getting 23.44 option. Very good. What's the value of x you are getting? What's the value of x? This will be 101 something. 101 RPM. 101.56. Okay, if 101.56, so this will be 23.44. And this is nothing but the value of y. और यही आपका आरपीएम 23 इज द करेक्ट आंसर. वेरी गुड. सिंपल, यू हैव टू गो विद दैट टेबुलर फॉर्म. आप टेबल बनाते थे ना, वही है. बट वंस यू प्रैक्टिस दैट क्वेश्चन 4 or 5 times, आफ्टर 6 व्हेन यू विल बी सॉल्विंग द 6th क्वेश्चन, द टेबल ड्रॉइंग इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. टेबल को बनाना इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड बिकॉज दैट इज बेसिकली वेस्टेज ऑफ टाइम, और मार्क में टाइम इज वेरी वेरी क्रूशियल. ठीक है, फाइन. एक टेक्निक बता देता हूँ, यू वोंट बी हैविंग एनी कंफ्यूजन. ऑलवेज रिमेंबर दैट द इनर मोस्ट गियर विल ऑलवेज बी इन द न्यूमरेटर TS, और जिसका निकाले दैट विल बी इन द डिनोमिनेटर TP. ध्यान रखिए, नेवर एवर विल बी हैविंग एनी कंफ्यूजन. ठीक है, जब ये ऐसा सिस्टम हो, 3 gear सिस्टम. Yes. चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन योर स्क्रीन. आर क्लियर है? यस और नो? एवरीवन, एवरीवन, इज दिस इज क्लियर? क्वेश्चंस हो रहे हैं ना? दिस क्वेश्चन, गियर ट्रेन के क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं. यू विल बी एक्सपेक्टिंग वन क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम गियर ट्रेन इन बार्क एग्जाम, एंड इट्स ओनली आई वुड रादर से 4 days इज लेफ्ट और 3 days इज लेफ्ट आउट फॉर द एग्जाम. तो 3 दिन आपको बस, यू हैव टू जस्ट रिवाइज द कंसेप्ट. कोशिश कीजिए, इफ पॉसिबल यू कैन गो फॉर द फुल लेंथ मॉक टेस्ट, इफ नॉट पॉसिबल नो वरीज. अब बस ये 2 दिन, नेक्स्ट 2 days करना है. लास्ट डे यू हैव टू कीप योर माइंड रेस्ट, कूल, काम एंड कम. चलिए नेक्स्ट, अ वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम फ्रिक्शन टॉपिक. द फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स डेवलप एट द कॉन्टेक्ट सर्फेस एज शोन द फिगर विल बी 40 newton, 10 newton, 50 newton और 90 newton. चलिए, व्हाट विल बी द मैग्नीट्यूड ऑफ द फ्रिक्शनल फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन दिस बॉडी. वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द फ्रिक्शन. इसमें भी बहुत कंफ्यूजन आ जाता है बहुत लोगों को, बट अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम. कैलकुलेट द लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन. कैलकुलेट द लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन. लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन इज इक्वल टू म्यू इंटू एन, दैट इज इक्वल टू म्यू इंटू 100, दैट इज इक्वल टू 50 newton. सो योर लिमिटिंग फ्रिक्शन इज 50 newton. ओके, but what is the force being applied? That is 40 newton. That means you are in the static case. Aap static condition mein ho. That means the force applied is equal to the friction force. This case mein jo friction force hoga, that will be, it will be equal to the 40 newton. Okay. In order to move this body, you have to apply a force of 50 minimum. वेरी गुड. हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून रितेश, गुड आफ्टरनून. चले आगे बढ़े. इजी क्वेश्चन पे टाइम ज्यादा वेस्ट नहीं करेंगे. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. ओके, परफेक्ट. लिंक ओ ए इज रोटेटिंग एट एन एंगुलर वेलोसिटी ऑफ 4 radians per second इन द काउंटर क्लॉकवाइज डायरेक्शन एज शोन इन द फिगर. वी आर हैविंग द एंगुलर एक्सेलरेशन विच इज ऑल्सो काउंटर क्लॉकवाइज 9 radians per second square. द लेंथ ओ बी, दिस इज पॉइंट बी, पॉइंट बी. Okay, OB is 4 meter. What is the magnitude of the absolute acceleration at point B? That means what is the acceleration at point B? They're asking. Chali, what is the acceleration at point B? So how many acceleration? We are having three acceleration. They will be having three acceleration: radial, tangential, and Coriolis. Calculate all the three with proper your directions. The sliding is radially inwards. ठीक है, sliding आपका radially inward हो रहा है. चलिए, now quickly. A, B, C, or D. So radial acceleration is r omega square. R omega square. R कितना है? OB is 4. Omega is 4 square. So this is equal to 64 meter per second. Clear? Let us talk about tangential. That is r into alpha. That is 4 into 9. 36 meter per second. Right? Okay. Talk about Coriolis's acceleration. That is 2 into v into omega. 2 into velocity of this sliding velocity. Kitna hai? 9 meter per second. 9 into omega is 4. So this is 654. 8. 72 meter per second. Okay, you have calculated the magnitude of each and every acceleration. Let's see what is the direction. AR, dekho, radial acceleration always towards the center. Always towards the center. Tangential acceleration always in the direction of alpha. This is your tangential acceleration. Tell me the direction of Coriolis. Left, right, inward or outward? Coriolis ka jo direction hoga, wo kis taraf hoga? Left hoga, right hoga, inward hoga or outward hoga? Left, right, inward or outward? It will be towards right. It will be towards right. Kyunki the body is sliding inwards. Agar wo inward slide kar raha hai, then definitely the direction of Coriolis will be opposite to that of omega. Agar omega left ja raha hai, then Coriolis will be towards right. So tangential Coriolis are in opposite direction. So I can say that your, okay, this is your tangential acceleration, this is your Coriolis acceleration, and this is your radial acceleration. So absolute acceleration at point B equal to under root of AR square plus AT minus A ka whole square. Okay, AR is 64 ka square plus AT minus AC, 36 minus 72 ka whole square ka under root. Okay, so this will be 64 ka square minus 36 square root. Calculate and tell me what's the answer you're getting. You'll be getting approximately 73.43 meter per second square, and the answer for this problem is option C. Answer to this problem is clear. Very good. Perfect. Answer to this problem is option C. Okay. Chale, next question. तो हाफ वे भी नहीं पहुंचे, वी आर नॉट येट कंप्लीटेड द हाफ वे. चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. अ पिनियन हैज 40 टीथ एंड मॉड्यूल हैज मॉड्यूल ऑफ 2 mm रोटेटिंग एट 800 आरपीएम ड्राइव्स अनदर गियर. इफ सेंट्रल डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द मेटिंग गियर इज 120 mm, द नंबर ऑफ टीथ ऑन द गियर एंड दैट ऑफ द स्पीड विल बी. वी आर हैविंग टू गियर, दिस इज स्मॉलर गियर एंड वी आर हैविंग अ बिगर गियर. ओके, नंबर ऑफ टीथ इज 40 एंड मॉड्यूल इज इक्वल टू 2 mm रोटेटिंग एट 800 rpm. So what you have to tell me, what is the number of teeth on gear number 2 and rpm? Simply we can eliminate option D, because definitely the rpm of gear number 2 will be lesser than that of gear number 1. So we can eliminate option D, right? Chaliye, quickly, central distance is given. So r1 plus r2 is given. R1 plus r2, this is the central distance, that is 120 mm. What is a module? That is d by t or 2r by t. Okay, so I can write this as m into t1 plus 2 by 2 into t1 by t2 by 2 is equal to 120. So you can apply and get the value of t2. T2 comes out to be 240 divided by 2 minus 40. 120 minus 40 is 80. Right, 80. So this can be eliminated. The T2 comes out to be 80. T2 comes out to be 80. T2 आपका 80 आ गया. What will be the RPM? You can go for RPM ratio. Right? You can go for RPM ratio. RPM ratio will be N2 by N1 is equal to T1 by T2. So that is equal to T1 कितना है? 40 by 8. Option C is the correct answer. Option C is the correct answer. Very good. 80 and 400 RPM are the number of teeth on gear number 2 and the RPM of 80 and 400. Very good. 80 and 400 RPM. Clear? Yes? Okay. Dekho, just by only calculating the value of T2, you can understand the value of RPM. Because T2 comes out to be 80. It is half of this. So half it is RPM be directly half. Ho jayega. No need to go for this calculation. Let me tell you the shortcut method. Agar aapka T is half, so definitely RPM be half ho jayega. Okay? Simple. Next question. In damped spring mass system, if mass is half and the stiffness is double, the logarithmic decrement is. If mass is half, M2 is equal to M1 by 2 and spring stiffness is doubled, K2 is equal to 2K1, what will be the change that is happening in logarithmic decrement? That means your delta value. What is the change that you are getting in delta value? What is delta? Delta is equal to 2 pi zeta divided by under root of 1 minus zeta square. So you have to check what is the change that you are getting in zeta. So zeta kya hota hai? That is equal to c by 2 under root k into m. C is not changing, k is changing, 2 and 1 by 2. Your zeta comes out to be same. Place this value, zeta same. If zeta is same, your logarithmic decrement will be same. Option c, that is options. Right, under root k into m, k is twice, mass is half, so that 2 and 2 will be cancelling out. So ultimately you will be getting damping factor is equal to damping factor for 1. 2 will be equal to 1. Very good. Option C is the correct answer. Perfect. Very good. Next question on your screen. Tell you. For a cantilever truss as shown in the figure, what is the force in the member BE? This is your member BE. Yeah, this is your member, this is point B, this is point E, and at point E we are having the forces like this, FB. Simple, very easy question. It will be having the same magnitude as of 60, so 50 can be eliminated, and that is tensile in nature. Option B, correct answer. Option B. The force in the member BE, kilonewton, tensile in. हमेशा याद रखिए, जब भी कोई फोर्स इट इज मूविंग अवे फ्रॉम द जॉइंट इट इज टेंसाइल इन नेचर, व्हेन इट इज मूविंग टुवर्ड्स द जॉइंट इट इज कंप्रेसिव इन नेचर. ऑप्शन बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. सिंपल क्वेश्चन. मैकेनिक्स, नो नीड टू वरी फॉर मैकेनिक्स, यू विल बी गेटिंग वेरी इजीयर क्वेश्चंस फॉर योर एग्जामिनेशन. चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन ऑन योर स्क्रीन. ओके, अ पार्टिकल एंटर्स इनटू अ स्मूथ फ्रिक्शनलेस सर्कुलर लूप ऑफ रेडियस आर at a point P. So this particle is entering the circular body at point P. If G is acceleration due to gravity, then minimum speed with which the particle should enter the loop such that it can complete one full revolution. It can complete one full revolution. Chaliye. What should be your approach? What should be your approach? Quickly. Let me this under root of this on the complete under root. Quickly, how to solve it? Now tell me when this particle will be reaching this position. Let's say this position is A. So at point A, when this particle reaches point A, so I can say the centrifugal force should be equal to the weight, that is mv square. Let's say the velocity at this point is 2, v2 square by r should be is equal to m into g, right? So v2 is equal to V2 is equal to root RG. V2 is equal to root R into G. You have to calculate what should be the velocity with which it is entering. So go for energy method. Okay? Go for energy method. Energy method laga dijiye. Energy conservation method. So half into M into V1 square should be equal to Mg into 2R plus half into M into V2 square. Yahi hoga? Thank you. So mass will be cancelling out. So V1 we have to calculate by 2. That is 2RG plus V2 square. This will be RG by 2. This is 5 by 2. Okay, so V1 comes out to V1 square is equal to 5RG. So V1 is equal to under root of 5. Option clear hai. Bottom pe maximum hona chahiye. That's perfect. But itna bhi nahi hona chahiye ki wo circular hi na ghume. It should be having an optimum value such that it is making a complete circle. So if this body is entering the circular loop with a velocity of root 5 RG, it will be making a complete full circular revolution. Okay, dekho, at this point only, we will be having the maximum force. At this point, aapka sabse zyada effective force hoga. That is your centrifugal force and that is your mg. It should be equal for complete revolution. Chaliye, next question. Okay. Refer to this inverted slider crank mechanism at the instant input crank, that is PS, is horizontal and perpendicular to the fixed link. And it is rotating with an angular velocity of 1.25 radian per second. So this is omega is 1.25 radian per second. What is the magnitude of Coriolis's action? What is the magnitude of Coriolis's action? Let's see who will be giving me the answer. It's a very unique, very important and very conceptual problem. This will be checking your understanding level in the velocity analysis. Velocity analysis, Coriolis's acceleration. 1.25, let me have this. Omega PS equal to 1.25 radian. How to calculate this particular question? Let us suppose this angle is theta. It's also theta. Okay. So if this is perpendicular, can you tell me what is the velocity at point S? It will be in this direction. This is the direction of Vs. That is equal to R into omega. Ye kitna hoga? This will be R into omega. So Vs, or I would rather say R into omega, what is R? That is equal to 400. Omega is equal to 1.25. So let us say this is equal to V. I'm denoting V is equal to R into omega, that is 1.25 into 100. 1.25 into 400 mm per second, right? Okay, chaliye. Now this velocity will be having two components. We have to take the two components of this velocity. Agar main thoda sa yahan pe magnify karke bana. A point. Talking about fixed link. This is your dotted plate. Right? This angle I'm assuming is at theta. This will also be okay. So let us suppose this is rotating with an angular velocity of omega, let's say this is OS, yeah, OQ. This point O, this is point Q, this point S. So what will be OQ? So I can say the velocity in this direction, let's say this is equal to V1. So V1 will be equal to OS into omega OQ. V1 will be equal to OS into, because this will be perpendicular. If this is perpendicular, this is theta, so this will also be theta. I can say V1 is basically equal to V cos theta. And V, what is V? V is equal to R into omega that we have already calculated. That is this. Right? Okay. So we have calculated the value of V1. Can we calculate the value of V omega OQ? Okay, dekho, for calculating Coriolis's acceleration, this 2 into velocity of the slider into omega of OQ. That we have to calculate. So we have individually nikalna padega. Chaliye. Now, can you tell me what is the angle theta? What is this angle? So, tan theta is equal to 3 by 4. So, what is the value of this theta? Theta kitna aa raha hai? Anyone? What is the value of this theta angle? Have you calculated this? It will be tan inverse 3 by 4. Aap nikal ke mujhe bata dijiyega. So, from here you can calculate V1, that is R into omega into cos theta divided by OS. What is the length OS? OS will be equal to 500 mm. Use Pythagoras theorem. Again, this will be divided by 5. To get the value of omega OQ. Got this omega OQ perfect. Next step is you have to get this velocity of sliding. Sliding velocity kya hai? In this direction, what is the sliding velocity? The iska kaun sa component? Sine component. 36.86. Or 37 degree, you can go for 37. Fine. So, velocity of sliding is equal to V sine theta. Velocity of sliding is V sine theta. Okay, so we got velocity of sliding, we got omega. Now we can get the value of Coriolis's acceleration. That is equal to 2 into 0.8 R. Very good. 0.8 radian per second. And velocity of sliding is. What is velocity of sliding? 300 mm per second. I think please check your answer. Chaliye. So now you can apply the value and get the answer. Chaliye quickly. So 2 into 0.3 into 0.8. 0.8. Right? So to be mm mein nikale. You have to calculate in mm. Have to calculate the value in mm. Very good. Your answer is 24 into 2, 48. Option B is the correct answer. 24 into 2, 480 mm per second. Here, option B is the correct answer. Dekho, ye question kyun important hai? It is basically cross-checking your understanding level. Many of you, बहुत बार ऐसे होता है वो zero mark करके आ जाते हैं. If you're having an option of zero also, they could have marked option. But इसका ध्यान रखिए, this velocity will be having two components. One will be in this direction, which will be acting as a sliding velocity, and one will be in this direction, which will be rotating this, which will be rotating this dotted plate. So individually, you have to calculate this this velocity, this velocity. This will be acting as a sliding velocity. This will be the rotational velocity for the slotted bar. Option. Correct answer. Okay. Clear, everyone. Bahut hi acha question tha ye from Coriolis's. Done. Yes or no? Very good. Perfect. Next question on your screen. Okay, a driver link AB of a 4-bar mechanism is rotated with 5 radian per second in counterclockwise, anticlockwise directly in the. The angular velocity of the coupler link, you have to tell me what is the angular velocity of coupler, that is omega B. You have to calculate if theta is equal to 180 degree. If theta equal to 180 degree, that means your diagram will be something like this. This A, this D, this. So let us write 1, 2, 3, 4. Get that. This will be I12. This is I3, 4, I1. What is omega BC? That is equal to omega 3. You have to calculate basically omega 3. You have to calculate. Okay. Omega 3 you have to calculate. And omega 2 is given as 5 radian per second. यू हैव टू टेक अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ विच, टू एंड थ्री, आपको टू एंड थ्री का कॉम्बिनेशन लेना पड़ेगा एंड थ्री का कॉम्बिनेशन, राइट. सो टू एंड थ्री मतलब आई वन टू, आई टू थ्री, आई, राइट. सो वन टू आई नो दिस इज आई वन टू, आई टू थ्री आई नो दिस इज आई टू थ्री. वट इज आई वन थ्री? फॉर कैलकुलेटिंग आई वन थ्री ड्रॉ सर्कल, वन थ्री नाइन, वन थ्री इज अ कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ वन टू एंड टू थ्री एंड वन फोर एंड थ्री, वन टू टू थ्री, वन टू टू थ्री लाइन, वन फोर थ्री फोर. तो दिस पॉइंट इज योर आई, पॉइंट डी इज ऑल. नाउ डायमेंशन इज डायरेक्टली गिवन, ए बी एंड ए डी आर इक्वल, दिस इज एल एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो एल. क्विकली चलिए, ए बी सी और डी, तो अप्लाई योर थ्योरम, ओमेगा टू आई वन टू आई टू थ्री इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा थ्री आई वन थ्री आई, ठीक है. ओमेगा टू ऑलरेडी इट इज बीइंग गिवन फाइव, वन टू टू थ्री, दिस इज वन टू, दिस इज टू थ्री, दिस इज इक्वल टू एल इज इक्वल टू ओमेगा थ्री इन टू वन थ्री टू थ्री, दिस इज वन थ्री, दिस इज टू थ्री, वॉट इज द टोटल डिस्टेंस, दैट इज इक्वल टू टू एल, इक्वल टू टू एल, ओमेगा थ्री कम्स आउट टू बी 2.5 रेडियन, 2.5 रेडियन पर सेकंड. ऑप्शन ऑप्शन ए इज, दिस इज क्लियर, यस, ऑप्शन ए इज वेरी गुड, वेरी सिंपल. आपको यू हैव टू यूज थ्योरम ऑफ एंगुलर वेलोसिटी, दैट्स इट, डन, क्लियर. Shall we proceed for the next problem? Tell the next question on your screen. A body having a mass of 15 kg is suspended from a spring which deflects 12 mm under its weight of the mass. The viscous damping force needed to make the motion aperiodic. You have to make the motion to be aperiodic. What is the damping force that you are having, provided that the speed is 1 mm, provided that the speed is 1 mm. Quickly, mass is given, deflection, static deflection is given, you have to tell me what should be the damping force in order to have a aperiodic motion. That means your zeta should be equal to 1, zeta equal to 1, okay. If zeta equal to 1, I can say C is equal to, C is equal to 2 under root K into M, right? Chaliye, quickly. How to calculate K? How to calculate K? Dekho, they are saying that 15 kg suspended from a spring which deflects 12 mm its own weight. That means 15 into G is equal to K into 12. So K is equal to 15 G by 12. This is Newton per mm. Newton per mm. This is the value of K. Okay. So you can get the value of C. 2 into under root. K value is 15 into 10 by 12 into 100,000 into mass is 15. Calculate and tell me what is the value you are getting. ठीक है, आपको ओमेगा एन भी निकाल सकते हैं. इफ यू वांट, इफ यू डोंट वांट टू गो विद दिस, यू कैन गो विद ओमेगा एन, दैट इज इक्वल टू अंडर रूट ऑफ जी बाय डेल्टा. सो सी सी इज इक्वल टू 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 एम ओमेगा एन. यू कैन कैलकुलेट बाय दिस मेथड ऑल्सो, इट्स अप टू यू, इट्स अप टू यू. यू कैन गो फॉर दिस मेथड, यू कैन गो विद दिस मेथड. अल्टीमेट यू विल बी गेटिंग द सेम वैल्यू. ठीक है, सो यू विल बी गेटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ सी टू बी. सी वैल्यू कितना आ रहा है? विल बी 0.857 न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर, न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर, राइट. ओके, 0.857 न्यूटन सेकेंड पर एमएम, न्यूटन सेकेंड पर एमएम आपका आ रहा है 0.857. So what is damping force? The damping force is equal to C into velocity. What is C? 0.857 into 1. So ultimately you'll be getting 0.857. Option B is the correct answer. You'll be getting 857 per, अगर आप मीटर में निकालते हैं, will be 857 per meter. Okay. Will be 857 per meter. This will be 857 into 10 to the power minus 3. 857 into 10 power minus 3. That logic will be getting directly option. ठीक है, if you want you can go for mm also, if you want you can go for meter also. क्योंकि हमने मीटर में लिया, this will be getting 857. Okay, so 857 into 10 to the power minus 3, because this is 1 mm per second. ठीक है, so you'll be getting directly the damping force equal to 0.85. 866 आ रहा है, हाँ देखो, CC will be giving 866 है क्या? 857 न्यूटन सेकेंड पर मीटर. द डैम्पिंग फोर्स इज इक्वल टू सी इन टू वेलोसिटी. तो 857 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 3, बिकॉज वेलोसिटी इज 1 mm पर सेकेंड, दैट इज पॉइंट. ठीक है, क्लियर है? यस, approximate values निकाल सकते हो आप, no worries. If you're getting 866 also, ultimately you'll be getting 0.866 newton. Round off करेंगे तो आपके पास 0.86 या 0.87 newton will be your final answer. चलिए next question on your screen. चलिए next question. A particle starts with velocity 2 meter per second and moves on a straight line. Its retardation is 0.1 meter per second square. The time at which the particle is 15 meters from the starting point would be, simple, your initial velocity is given 2 meter per second, retardation is minus 0.1 meter per second, distance traveled, so you can go for s is equal to ut plus half at square, half 15, 2 into 2t, 2 into t minus half into 0.1 into square, t 100 square minus 40, your equation. This t minus 30 and t minus 10, so t comes out to be 10 and 30. So the correct answer is, now why we are getting 10 two values of t? Why we are getting two values of t? Can anyone tell me? Let us suppose aapka ye body tha, was moving with some velocity. Okay, so after 10 seconds it will be reaching 15 meter. Yahan se yahan tak pahunchenge, it will be taking 10 seconds. Theek hai, 10 seconds, right? Fine, but what is happening? This is retardation process. After some point of time, ये value आपका zero हो जाएगा. It will be having the final velocity equal to zero, and again it will be accelerating. So after 30 seconds, it will be again back to this position. So total time is basically 30 seconds. Okay, that is why we are having two time period. Give it is calculating 10 and 30. 10 means at the starting it will be crossing this point 15 meter after 10 seconds, and again it will be crossing that same point after 30 seconds. ठीक है, वेलोसिटी यहाँ पे जीरो के बाद इट विल बी कमिंग विद एन एक्सेलरेशन ऑफ 0.1. रिटार्डेशन मींस इट विल बी हैविंग सम एंड पॉइंट इक्वल टू जीरो, आफ्टर दैट विल बी हैविंग योर वेलोसिटी. दिस इज क्लियर, यस और नो? चलिए नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, इजी क्वेश्चन है, बहुत इजी क्वेश्चन. In a four bar mechanism as shown in the figure, the velocity of the crank is 1 radian per second. Crank is 1 radian per second in the clockwise. AB is your crank. AB, omega AB is equal to 1 radian per second in the clockwise direction. Okay. What is the angular velocity of the coupler BC? What is the angular velocity of the coupler BC? The length is given 5, 6 and 7. How to calculate omega of B? Again, go with that velocity method, IC method. Link 1. Link 2, link 3, link number 4. This is 1, 2, 3. This is I 3, 4. and this is I14, right? And you have to locate 13. 13 is basically, निकाला 1 4. 13 is a combination of 1 2 and 2 1 4. So 1 2 and 2 3 and 1 4 and 3 4, this is the same point, that is I 13. चलिए quickly, what will be the value of omega BC? Omega 2 I 12 I 13 is equal to omega 3 I 13 13, ठीक है? Omega 2 is 1 1 2 2 3 1 2 2 3, this distance is 5, is equal to omega 3 into 13 and 23, this is 6. Omega 3 comes out to be 5/6 in per second. 5/6 radian per second, right? Now we are having two options having same magnitude but having different values. If you see, I23 is over here, 12 is this side, 13 is over this side. So definitely opposite side, according to sign convention, if omega 2 is rotating clockwise, then omega 3 will be rotating in an anti-clockwise direction. Option D is the correct answer. Option D is the correct answer. Is this clear? Mithun, Parvinda, Nitesh, option D will be your correct answer. Okay. Yes. Done. Option D, 5/6 counterclockwise direction. Chaliye, next question. Chaliye, quick response. A vibrating system consists of mass of 100 kg and spring of stiffness 500 kN per meter and a damper. The damper provided is only 10% of the critical value. What is the ratio of two consecutive amplitudes? That means you have to tell me what is the ratio of xn divided by x plus 1 to e to the power delta. What is delta? Delta is equal to 2 pi zeta divided by under root of 1 zeta square. Okay. Zeta value is equal to c by 2 root k into m. quickly. Now, no need to calculate this zeta like this. It is C by CC. And C is equal to 0.1 of C. C by CC will be equal to 0.1. Zeta is directly 0.1. Put the value of zeta equal to 0.1, you'll be getting the answer. Put the value of zeta is equal to 0.1, you'll be getting the value of delta. And e to the power delta, that will be the final. So 2 pi into 0.1 divided by into 0.1 divided by under of 1 delta value aa jayega, so e to the power delta will be your final answer. This comes out to be very good, Parvinder. Delta value comes out to be 0.63. Okay, delta is 0.63, so e to the power 0.63 is 1.88. without calci nahi hoga, you have to use calculators, just like in bark exam. Park exam mein, you will be using the calculators, right? Yes or no? Okay, perfect. Option B is a correct answer. Very good, Gaurav. Very good. Chale, next question. Bas easy pace ke saath chalna hai. Two cylinders are kept in container as shown in the figure below. The top of the cylinder, the top cylinder is having weight W, the bottom cylinder is having a weight of 2W. What is the reaction at point A? So Lamy's theorem, you can go for Lamy's theorem and you can get the answer. You can go for the Lamy's theorem and get the answer quickly. Let me hide myself for the dimensions. So if I draw the free body diagram of point A, we'll be having a RA acting like this, having RA. Plus only two more questions are left out. Only two more questions are left. Then you are free to go. This is your 2W. You're having one reaction like this. You draw the free body diagram, body A, FBD of FBD, W are the weight, having RA in this direction, having a reaction force, let's say this R, having 2W, right? And anything else? Let's suppose this angle is theta. What is this angle? How to calculate this angle? So this is 20 plus 30. 20 plus 30, 50. Okay. How to calculate this angle? This is 30. This is 20. 30 minus 20. So this will, this distance will be 50. This distance will be 50. Are you getting the point? ये देखो radius है, so this distance will be 30, और यहाँ से यहाँ तक the distance will be 20, so 20 plus 30 is 50, 80 minus 50 is 30, ये 30 हो जाएगा, 80 minus 50 is 30, so this distance is 30, so we are having like this, this is theta, 30, and this total length is. You can get the value of theta. So theta will be equal to sine theta. Cos theta is equal to, cos theta will be equal to 355. The value of theta. Fine. So RB, RA is equal to, RA is equal to RB cos theta. What is RB? Draw the free body diagram of the upper portion. So we are having W like this, we'll be having or reaction that R. So RB sine theta is equal to W, right? So quickly, RB is equal to W by sine theta. So RA is equal to W tan theta. W by 10. Tan theta is, sine theta will be equal to 4 by 5. Tan theta is W. Option D is the correct answer. Dekho, you have to proceed the question very carefully. You have to proceed the question very carefully. Bahut easy questions rehte hain, but mechanics ka khas baat ye hai, you will be getting questions like this in which you feel that it's very difficult, but it's very, okay. Option D, is this clear? Quickly, after that two more questions is left out, so you have to tell me the correct answer. Quickly, done. So let's do one thing, let's let me give two questions as homework, and you can comment in the comment section after the class is being. Okay. Is this clear? Done. Chaliye. So next two questions are homework. You can comment in the comment section. This is question number one as homework. Okay. This is question number one as homework. We are having a constant force fortnight wind is applied to the piston. Its velocity is found to be 0.12 meter per second. What is the type of motion? So abhi kar lete hain. Let's. Last question will be the question. Chaliye. So you can go for your damping, that is 49 by 0.12. This is the value of C. The value of C. Calculate the value of zeta. Zeta is equal to C by 2 root K into M. Calculate the value of zeta. Zeta kitna aa raha hai? By based on that zeta value, we can directly say what is the type of motion. Is it harmonic, periodic, aperiodic, or random? C kitna aa raha hai? K value is 425. 245 newton per meter, mass is 15 kg. You got the value of C, 49 by 0.12. Tell me quickly, this will be 408 something, 408.33 newton second per meter, right? You calculate the value of zeta, it will be greater than 1. Zeta will be greater, approximately 3 point R, na? We're getting approximately 3.367 exactly. This is the value of zeta, that means this is an over damped system. And if the system is overdamped, we do not having vibration, no vibration, there is no vibration, that means this is our aperiodic system. The aperiodic system. This is clear? This is nothing but an aperiodic system. Done? Yes? Understood? Aperiodic system. Perfect. Chaliye. So last question is homework for you guys. This question is homework for you. Homework question. Okay, you can comment in the comment section. The height is 30 meter. The base is 50 meter. Okay. The question is, a 5 kg block is released from the rest at position A. This is position number A. It's inclined as shown in the figure 30 and 50. If the coefficient friction is mu is equal to 0.2, what is the velocity with which it will touch the ground, that is at point B? What is the velocity? What is the velocity at point B? Is this clear? Okay, A, B, C, or D, you can calculate and you can tell me in the comment section. And the PDF will be shared with you in the Telegram channel that I have shared. So this completes the practice session for theory of machine and engineering mechanics in totality. Make sure you are practicing and revising and you are giving your best for the bar. Okay, so there's a class going on of marathon. It is already being started at 2 o'clock. You just attend that and get your revision, formal revision. Okay, bar ke liye formal revision chal raha hai Hindi YouTube channel pe. Aap wahan jayenge aur wahan par aap revision. Okay, so thank you guys. Take care, stay safe. I'll be joining that marathon at around 5:30 or 6 o'clock. Okay, thank you. Bye bye.